What's going on, everybody? JBH here, and welcome back to another video. Today, guys, we are actually going to go to Hershey's Chocolate World today and see any updates. I do hear that they have now, at the very end of the tour ride, the Hershey's Great American Chocolate Bar song has finally arrived. So we're going to check and see if that is true or not. I hope so. I can't wait to see that and hear that. So let's go and see what any other updates that Chocolate World may have today. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Looks like right outside Chocolate World they have a sign up showing about the Hersheyland Express, the Great Candy Expedition, a cinematic adventure coming this summer. It opens on May 19th, so we'll definitely have to go to this once it opens. And outside, they still have the 50th statue right now outside, so you can take a picture with it as well for the remainder of the for their 50th seasons. But let's go inside of Chocolate World. Alrighty, so we made it inside Chocolate World. Today is Friday, April 28th. It is raining outside today. It's supposed to be raining all weekend, but let's go and see what updates we can get. Alright, it looks like the new display is up. So all Easter is away, so now it's all Jolly Rancher themed Twizzlers. So mostly Jolly Rancher. So of course for their summer time now, they're getting their summer look ready. Alright, but first thing we're gonna do is let's go on the new chocolate tour ride.
Which get extremely hot. Toasty in here, isn't it? Next, we quickly cool the beans and feed them into our breaking chamber, which cracks open the shells at high speed. Inside each shell are tiny pieces called cocoa nibs.
The grinding turns cocoa nibs into the smooth, dark liquid used to make milk and dark chocolate.
Thank you. that goes into making every piece of Hershey's goodness.
Come visit us again soon.
Please remain seated until the door opens and watch your step on a moving platform. And enjoy the rest of your day here at Hershey's Chocolate World. So long, everyone.
Thanks for coming.
Bye-bye.
Alrighty everyone, so we just got off the tour ride. So yes, the song is now back in at the very end. So I was hoping that it would be like kind of like the original, like a song. It was basically the video that they released. It was basically just the video on the screen. I mean, I think it's a good effort, but for me personally, me being the musical person that I am, I would have just like had it re-recorded. And then like that, instead of just putting like the video, it was basically the YouTube video that they post, that Chocolate World posted, and they just put it at the end of the ride. I mean, it's still great that we finally got the song at the very end, but I could see that's why they would eventually, it's like, it's only going to be here temporary. But I mean, hopefully, you know, in the future, they can actually put like the actual like original song back in, like, because it'd be cool, because I think that what makes, you know Hershey's, you know, because it's the Great American Chocolate Bar. No offense to, you know, to that new song, The Taste of Love. I get that song, but I think they should get rid of that song, because that's just my opinion. If you like that song, great. But that's just my opinion, you know, being growing up with this ride, you know, since the 90s and early 2000s, because that was the best tour ride, you know, in that version. Like, I think the one in like the early 2000s, because that's the one I remember growing up with. But it's a really good ride, you know, definitely always, it's the must-do when you come to Chocolate World. So check it out now, because now the song is now back in on the ride. Alright, and as you exit the ride, they have now, Hershey's is now partly partnered with Loungefly. So right here is, of course, the new Reese's bag. They don't have too much left. It is $90. So it looks like there's a limit, only 3 per person. I actually already did pick one of these up. So there's not too many left, so if you want that bag, get it soon. I'm hoping this is going to be like the start of the partnership with Loungefly. Eventually will they get, you know, of course, a Hershey's one, like a Kisses one, like all the different chocolate. They could do lots of different versions with that, so hopefully in the future they will get more Loungeflies with the different brands. Alright, now I'm just looking through the store a little bit. So I'm just gonna look around a little bit. I was thinking about getting this hat, because I like this Hershey's hat, because it's like chocolate. I have the Reese's one already. But yeah, I might get this hat. That hat is, over there, $19.95. Ooh, looks like they do have a new, the Kissmobile, magnet now you can get. Which is, I'm trying to see right there, all the prices of the magnets. But yeah, might be $5.95. Yeah, but they still have the 50th one. I did get a 50th one already. But it looks like they have some new ones. Alright, looks like here they have a large character-shaped blanket for $37.95. It's like kind of soft. It has all the characters on it, which is awesome. But then over here, looks like this is new Jolly Rancher. It's a plush bag set. So it looks like it has all the different flavors in there. So that's pretty cool. And of course, they have the assorted small plush at $14.95. It has all the characters: Kiss, Hershey, Reese, Twizzler, but still no Jolly yet. We need the new Jolly. And of course, he can make a s'mores. Also, one thing I forgot to mention about the tour ride, as you can see, that they have special photographs from throughout Chocolate World's history, from when they first opened, showing all the tour rides at different moments during their history. So, which is really cool. Make sure you check that out as you're in the queue for the tour ride. So right now for Reese's, right now they're doing if you're team creamy or team crunchy, and then you have to vote on which one you think would be the best. I'm not gonna get one of each. I think I'm more team creamy, but who knows, I'll get one of each and we'll find out.
Of course, they do have Reese's with Reese's Puff inside, so you can try that. Right, over here is, of course, their summer display featuring Twizzlers and Jolly Rancher. But right here, yep, you can take a photo right here, and that'll be your photo op. And of course, still on display at the food court is, of course, the lovely 50th sculpture. Looks like they moved some 50th stuff back here you can buy right now. So they have some back here. But back here, this is where you would meet the characters on weekends. I think they do weekends only right now. But of course, right here is everything you would need for the 50th. So alrighty guys, so I got a couple things and I got some cookies. So we'll take that all that home then. Okay, so the worker up ahead just gave me this. So apparently they are testing out the attraction right now. So let's go see. Alright, so I'm not allowed to film after this point, but right here is of course the main station. Look how cool this is, featuring all the different, you know, Jolly Rancher. There's Jolly Rancher, there's almonds, like all different like points to visit. It's really cool. Looks just like a train station. Alright, and also you just got a passport they hand out, so we'll have to check that out then too. Alright, and they also said, so if you scan these QR codes, it'll something will happen if you scan the QR codes, which is cool. Hershey land map. Alright everyone, so we just got off the Great Candy Exhibition. I did not expect to do this today. So right now, it was free, I didn't have to pay right now, because the tickets don't go on sale until May 10th, because their grand opening is not until May 19th. But it was really nice to do that. Right now they're doing audience just like testing for it, like previews for it right now. So it was great to finally do that. Like I said, there is no filming when you get to the actual into the actual theater part. So like I said, I only filmed a little bit at the actual station, and then you'll see, I'll post here a picture then that actually you'll board the train, and that's when you go into like the theater, but you're supposed to be in a train. So it was really cool. Like I said, it's more interactive than the last, like the 3D show. I said, I think I love this a lot better because the smells, there's so many different smells, because all the different lands you go to, you'll have different smells. And it's, like I said, it's more interactive. They have like action buttons and arrows on your seat, and you'll choose like which area you want to go, like the Twisted, like the Kit Kat area or the Jolly Rancher area. So it feels like this ride could have different multiple outcomes depend which land, because it's by audience participation. So it's really more interactive, and it's just really cool with all the different smells. And I definitely recommend it. Like, we'll definitely be back for this attraction. So make sure you do it here at Hershey's Chocolate World this summer. It's a great addition, of course, for their 50th anniversary. Right, and here is the passport that you get when you start. So let's take a look about it, a little bit about it. So basically, it's like a field guide. Oh yeah, that was the train engineer, Ginny. She was on it. Her voice she sounded like the voice was Anna Kendrick to me, but I don't know. But see, like I said, so this is what I was saying, like Kisses Valley or like Almond Joy Cove. Like you can, like audience participation, you can choose which land you want to go visit. So it looks like here they have a lot of different, you know, word puzzles. So it looks like it's a little fun activity kit you can do. Like I said, you can scan the QR codes to explore more. We didn't get to go to Jolly Rancher Junction. I choose that one, but we ended up going to Kit Kat Timbers instead. But yeah, so this is really cool. We did go to Reese's Ridge. Oh, that was amazing. But yeah. So this is where you're seeing all the clues. So like I said, it's a nice little, you know, activity book, you know, to get. So it's really cool. So yeah, so make sure you pick up one of those passports. All right, and as you exit the ride, you get a full-size Hershey's milk chocolate bar. How about that? Get that as you exit. All right, everyone, so we're about to leave Chocolate World now. Still raining, so yeah, still raining. Alrighty, everyone, so that's gonna do it for our day here at Chocolate World. So like I said, we just did a little bit of its updates, walked around a bit, and we got to do the Great Candy Expedition. You know, I did not expect to do that today, so that was really cool we got to do that today. It's definitely worth that. It definitely, like I said, right now they are in previews for it, so they're only testing, so they want an audience just to see how it goes. It's really good, like everything, I mean, with everything, you know, the sights, the smells are all that chocolate smells, basically, you'll smell, but it's really cool. And also, like, I forgot to mention also, so it is in, like, the same area, the theater, as the past, you know, two 3D shows that they had, but now they actually condensed the theaters a lot smaller. They took out a lot of the seats, so it won't be as crowded of a show. But now, like, the screens are, like, all around, they're, like, all around you, so it really looks like, you know, like you're moving, like you're in a train. So keep that in mind in case you have, if you're prone to, like, motion sickness, that might make you a little, you know, lightheaded or anything if you're prone to that. So just keep that in mind. But yeah, it's a great experience. Like I said, it's like, thank you, Chocolate World. You know, that's just a great, you know, add-on. For their 50th anniversary for this year. But anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoy this video today. So until then, I'm JBH, and until the next adventure, I'll see you guys real soon. See ya.